Let's go.
What is going on, guys, and welcome back to 777 Riding. So it's been a seems like it's been a while since I made a video. Anyways, it's been a while since I made a video, and it is a nice day out today, and I kind of feel like doing some riding, you know. My cousin and her friend are here today visiting, and we're introducing them to beautiful areas up here. So I think today we're gonna go from Idaho City to the North Fork of the Boise River, and I don't know how far that, like, right now we're about the halfway point, so I just thought, you know, jump off my bike and do a little riding. And I don't know how much further it is. Maybe about 10 more miles or something, I guess. So that's not bad. So, bike's still running well, and do a little bit of riding. I got a bad cramp in my leg or something. It really hurts. I didn't do anything, so it's kind of weird, but legs cramp up sometimes. I know some of you may have expected me to make a video for Labor Day weekend, but it was actually also the opening weekend of elk season, so we actually went on a elk hunting and backpacking trip. We didn't get anything though, but it was actually pretty fun. And I did bring my GoPro just in case we got into some action, but that didn't quite happen. But like I said, it was still pretty fun. All right, let's see what the sign says. North Fork of Boise River. No miles or no numbers or anything, so should be coming up here pretty soon. Okay, so we made it to the North Fork. It is down there, and I don't know where we're gonna go. We're probably gonna find like a neat little spot where there's gonna be a bunch of trails to go right up and down and stuff. So yeah, see what we can find here. Yay. I think I got a loose valve or something. Tighten it. Alright, guys, so we got to the day spot that we're staying. Just the day, and I went across this bridge here, and there's some really, really neat areas over here. Like, look at that. It looks like a fun hill climb right there. Had to get kind of a little speed there, but it looks pretty fun. Let's go see what's over here. Little track. Oh wow, look at this. I'm not that good at tracks, but they're pretty fun though, I have to say. Oh, you hear that? I'm getting kind of heavy for this bike. That's why I'm getting a new one next year. This area is pretty fun, Sonny. I wish Red Monster 999 was here. Yeah, he's got a race bike, and he'd love this track here. And looks like we got a little bit of a hill climb up here. Let's get some speed here and see how it is. Hopefully I don't get stuck.
Not neutral.
about to almost fail there. Oh my god, that was kind of crazy. I thought I was going to stall up there. Thank god I didn't though. Woo! That was actually pretty fun though. Okay guys, I have no idea what just happened, but my bike just locked up and shut off. I tapped the Kickstarter, she still turns over, but I don't know. So I looked at my chain, it was like caught up in my front sprocket. So the good news is, it still turns over. Well, I think it still turns over at number two. Just part of riding, stuff's gonna go bad. Luckily, truck's just right across the river over there, and the bridge is just right here, so show you guys here in a second when I get back to the bike. Alright guys, so it looks like the chain came off of the rear sprocket. I don't even know how I'm gonna get that thing back on. Got a couple ideas, but I don't think I'll be able to ride anymore for the rest of the day. First things first, we're gonna shift this thing into neutral and see if she still runs. If she doesn't run, I'm gonna cry literally because I love this bike. Do anything stupid, I wasn't going off jumps, but this is not a race bike, this is an enduro bike. So though it shouldn't, I don't know what happened. Let's go ahead, shift in neutral. Kick stand up. I got money because my Kickstarter doesn't seem to want to work. I'm going to hold the clutch in and see if she pops. Yeah, she still fires. She'll go into neutral. Shift down. Oh yeah, shifter doesn't work. Well, luckily, I got some money to go get this thing fixed. I'm selling it anyways next year, so probably sell for more if it's got a new shifter. Okay, my shifter must have jammed up or something. And my engine still starts, which is good. Well, it's gonna be a little ways of walk back, so. Okay guys, so the problem was is that my chain fell off my rear sprocket. Thank God that was the only problem. I was really scared there for a sec. I thought like something in my shifter broke, but everything is okay, which is good. Yeah, this bike is freaking tough. Though, you know, since we're gonna be selling it next year, I gotta be extra careful when I ride because I don't want anything else to go bad. Seems like everything's okay. My sprocket teeth look okay. Chain itself looks okay. It It is loose though, that's why it originally fell off. So I do need to tighten that when I get home. But other than that, we're just gonna do a little bit more riding around and take it a little bit easy when we're going off jumps and stuff. And then yeah, so still making sure everything's okay. Well guys, thank you very much for watching this video. That was a pretty fun day. I'm glad that the whole chain issue wasn't major or anything. Yet, just was a loose chain, and went ahead and made that adjustment. It's a nice little simple adjustment. It was originally on 15, and I have to had to move it up a couple notches. And now, seems okay. Seems a little bit tighter. So yeah, that's all good. And, yeah, it was pretty fun checking out a new area. I think we'll definitely go back to that area. That was a really cool place to ride. And yeah, it was nice to get the bike back on the track again. And, yeah, so anyways guys, make sure you give that like button a good rev, and yeah, if you're new, or if you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you all in my next upload, which will be pretty soon, and yeah, hope you all have an awesome rest of your weekend, and peace out.